Alright guys, so today we'll be talking about fundamental analysis, the basis, how to carry out fundamental analysis on projects that you are interested in. And to do that, there are a few things we are going to be looking at. But first of all, we are going to be doing our fundamental analysis using CoinGecko as a case study. Although CoinGecko is not the only available crypto encyclopedia out there, we have CoinMarketCap. We have CoinMarketCap also, and then we have this, right? And then we have Nomix.com. So these are websites you can use to get details about any assets that you are looking at. So, but meanwhile, I prefer using CoinGecko as my case study. So we're going to be using CoinGecko. Now, there are a few things you need to consider before or when you want to carry out fundamentals on any asset. So this more like things that you need to focus on. You need to just filter the noise and then focus on these things that I'm going to be talking about, right? So I've grouped the fundamental analysis you need to do into basically three categories, right? And we'll be looking at each of these categories in the long run, right? So let's start with the first one. We have the first one as project metrics. Now when we talk about the project metrics, we are talking about the structures upon which the project is developed. Structures such as the teams behind it, such as the white paper of the project, also such as events surrounding the project, right? These are very important considerations to look at. Now, events have a very huge impact on projects and their price action, right? So we are going to be looking at all that. Now, when we talk about the team behind the project, now let's find the case study. Now let's look at Polkadot. Let's look at Polkadot, for instance. But before we go on to that, let me take a bit of time to explain to you what you're looking at here on CoinGecko, right? Now CoinGecko here, you have, like I mentioned before, CoinGecko is like the encyclopedia of cryptocurrency. Any cryptocurrency that is not enlisted here should not be considered because there is no official record of it anywhere, right? So CoinGecko is like the encyclopedia or dictionary of all cryptocurrencies. So whatever information you want to get about any project, you can get it here on CoinGecko by just searching for the project, right? But before we go on to that, let me just take you through the website so that you at least know what you're looking at. The mobile version for CoinGecko is still the same thing you're looking at here, right? So let's go through the tabs that you're looking at here, the menus, right? Now under menu, this is menu, we have coins, right? Now we have all the coins according to their market cap rank, according to their recently added, according to the category they fall in, right? Now you can, this is more like when you're trying to sort, the coins you're looking at on the list. So you can sort them by market cap rank, which is the default. You can sort them by recently added if you want to see projects that were just added to the to CoinGecko. If you want to sort them by category, if you want to sort them by large movers, volume, and the rest of them, so that is what you get here. Now, for instance, we have it as this is according to market cap. Now let's switch it to recently added, so you get an insight of what I'm talking about. Okay, so this is it, to spool out all the assets that were added recently to CoinGecko. For instance, you can see this one was added 4 hours ago, 5 hours ago, 6 hours ago, 7 hours ago, just like that. So that is what I'm talking about. So whereas the default is market cap rank, right? So that is one. Now two, you get a list of exchange where you can buy your assets on spot, on decentralized exchanges, and then derivatives. These are the three categories of exchange we have. Exchanges where you can do your spot trading, decentralized exchange, and exchange where you can trade derivatives. Derivatives are futures contracts, right? Leverage trading, that is what we have here. Okay, so another thing you need to know is also that you can equally use CoinGecko as a portfolio management. Can use it to manage your portfolio instead of consistently running through a list of all your assets on exchange. You can easily, give me a minute please. Okay, so you can easily create a portfolio here on CoinGecko where you can have a single list of all the assets you're holding, right? Now let's assume these are all the assets I have in my portfolio. Now I have all these on different exchange and decentralized exchange, right? So I cannot be moving from one exchange to the other just so that I can, you know, follow up with my assets. So by coming to CoinGecko and creating a portfolio, it gives you the opportunity to add all the assets you are holding. Now for you to be able to do that, you need to know the particular price you bought the asset. You need to know the particular price you bought each coin. You need to know the quantity you bought. Right, now you need to also know the date you bought it, and then you create. Now when you do this, it will start tracking your portfolio for you. So it will start, you know, checking your PNL. PNL is profit and loss, so it will start checking it for you. So what you need to do is, when you just come here, you just look at your PNL, you know, if you're making profit or loss on your assets without having to, you know, go over your different exchange, just to get an insight on how your assets are doing, on how your assets are performing. Okay, so that is one important thing that CoinGecko helps you do, right? So just like I said, you can also see right here that it tells you the total market cap of the entire crypto market, right? This is 2.3 trillion. That's what the whole crypto market is right now. This is like the amount of money that is in the crypto market, $2.3 trillion, right? Now we have this as 24-hour trading volume, right, across all exchanges, right? Now this is the Bitcoin dominance. This is the Bitcoin dominance. This also helps you checkmate it. Whereas this one tells you the number of assets that are enlisted in the crypto markets, officially enlisted in the crypto market. You get it here. Now, I also said you can decide to view this according to their category. So you can see that we have different categories of all the cryptos in the market. We have them here, so you can decide that you want to see all the entertainment related assets. Once you click on this, it will spool out all the assets that are related to entertainment, right? You can see Theta there for streaming, you can see Mana, and you can see some other ones, you know. So just like that. And then if you decide you want to switch to another category, you know, assets that are related to education, see, it will do the same thing. All right, so that is that about how all the things you're seeing here on CoinGecko. So let's take a deep dive into CoinGecko so that we really know how we can use it. Now let's assume there is an asset you want to, you're looking for, right, and you want to get detailed information about that asset, right? So all you need to do is use the search button, and then you can search for it, right? Now when you search for it, it will spool out all the assets related with that ticker, and then you can select the one you're looking for, right? Now let's assume we're looking into audio. We want to invest into audio, but we want to first of all get an insight of, you know, what the project looks like. Now right here, you see it tells you the market cap. It tells you the market cap of the assets, right? Now the market cap is the total amount of money that has been invested into the project, right? So this is $829 million has been invested so far into audios, right? Now this is the current price of audios. This is the percentage in gain it has made in the last 24 hours. This is the percentage in BTC. This is the performance against Ethereum, right? Okay, so this is the current price. You know, this is like a price range that it has been trading, you know, on in the last 24 hours. So it has been trading between this level here and this level in the last 24 hours. Now you can also see that aside from the market cap, it tells us 24 hour trading volume. You know, it tells us how much money has been traded, you know, on audios in the last 24 hours. So as we can see here, we have $17 million so far that have been traded by trading, both buying and selling, right? Now we have the circulating supply. Now this is the circulating supply. Circulating supply tells you the total amount of the asset that is in the market, right, that is circulating in the market, that people are holding either in exchange or in wallets, right? So whereas the total supply is like the total amount of the asset that was created, right? So when this equals this, it means that when the circulating supply equals the total supply, it means that all the assets that was, you know, created, all the number of assets that was created is circulating in the market, you know, has been bought up by people in the market. So that is what it means. So sometimes total supply and max supply differs in the sense that some projects would have in mind certain conditions, you know, for more of their tokens to be printed, right? So for instance, let's assume Audios has a mechanics in their white paper that says every time the circulating supply or every time the market caps drops below $800 million, that more assets will be minted. So that is just a case like that. So there are projects you see that their total supply does not equal the market supply. Just know that there have been structures put, you know, in place to print more of the token if certain conditions are met, right? Whereas there are some that you see that both of them are equal, right? So another important information you can get from CoinGecko is blockchain that the asset, you know, is minted. We all know this is a symbol for Ethereum, right? So without too many thoughts, you can easily identify that, okay, this project is Ethereum based, is, you know, created on the Ethereum blockchain, right? So this here is a contract address. We know what a contract address is. Contract address is like your unique bank account number, where if it's queued in, it will automatically spool out your details, right? So that is how contract address is. So contract address is like the unique, you know, identification number of projects that you can use to, you know, get detailed information about them, right? Now, for instance, let's copy this contract address. Let's open a new tab. Let's open Etherscan. Let's open Etherscan. Right. So I can paste the contract address I copied here, and Etherscan will bring out the asset that is related to that contract address I just pasted, and it will give us all the informations that we can, you know, that we can get about it, like the creator address, the name tags. You can see it has pulled out audio here to tell you the token and the total supply and everything, right? So we can do that. You can also get that. So that is what you get here. Now this or gives you links to the website. This gives you direct links to the website of any project. So this, by clicking on this, it will take you directly to the website for the project you are looking into, whereas the next one takes you to their blog, right? So it also gives you a list of all their communities, all their social media handles, right? You can see that Audios is on Reddit, on Twitter, on Instagram, on Discord, on LinkedIn, right? So that is all the community they belong to. So we'll talk about community later. You can see that it took us directly to the Audio website, right, where you can easily you know, look into the project if you want, right? So that is that. Now going down, we can see that it also gives us a chart. It also gives us a chart of the performance of audios in the market. Now this chart right now is showing according to the last 24 hours. Now if we switch it to 7 days, you get the chart also on how it has been performing. If you switch it to 14 days, just like that. If you want to see how it has been performing in the last 30 days, you can see 90 days. You can also see, if you want to see the max since the token was launched, you also get that here. Now another thing you get from CoinGecko is the ROI, the reward of investments for this, for any asset over the long period of time that it has been in the market. Now you can see that Audios in the last 1 year has made a total profit of 969% for its investors. So now let's assume you have invested in Audios from the inception till this moment. You'll be up by this figure. Now this one is the performance in the last 30 days, in the last 14 days, just like that till the last 1 hour. Okay, so that is what you get here. Another thing you get is the market, right? It also gives you a list of all the exchange where you can purchase audio. So you can see that audio is listed in all this exchange we're looking at right now. Binance, Gate, Uniswap, FTS, and the rest of them, right? So whichever one that suits you, you can just, you know, click on it to take you directly to the website for you to make your purchase, right? Okay, let's go back to overview. Another thing you get here is okay, there's no brief data on audios. There's no brief data on audio. So let's look at this section, the price and market statistics, right? Now this is just like a breakdown of everything that we have been talking about with a few addition. Now, this is the price of audios. This is the market cap. It tells you here the dominance in the market, trading volume, and just everything that I've explained initially, but more like a summary of it here, right? Now it tells you the market cap rank, like the rank according to market capitalization. It tells you it's all-time high, right? And when the date when the all-time high was hit, it tells you it's all-time low, the percentage in return, and the date that it hits that all-time low. Whereas this one is for the last 24 hours, you know, the highest it has gone and the lowest it has gone in the last 24 hours. So in the last 24 hours, the lowest audio has gone is 1.58 and the highest it has gone is 1.65. Now in the last 7 days, the same thing as you can see here, right? So this here is just a breakdown of everything that I have explained. So going back to what I was explaining earlier on the things to look out for when you're, you know, performing your fundamental analysis, all these things that I've mentioned here, all these things that I've talked about here are solid points that you need to look at. You want to know the total supply. Even though upon visiting the website you should get the, you know, that kind of information, but then you can easily take a look at it here, you know, take a look at the market cap, you know, how much money has been invested into it, and the rest of it. So it's also important that you look at that. So now let's get a project that we can use as a case study. I want to use Matic because Matic should have enough information. Matic should have enough information for us. So we are going to use Matic. Now let's go to the website of Matic. Now, going to the website, there are a few things that we are interested in, right? We want to take a look at some, you know, some of the project metrics to see how these projects interest us, right? Now I said one of the things you want to look at is the team behind the projects. Now when you go to the website, you want to see the team behind the project, right? You want to vet the team, you want to see how reliable this team, you know, and their reputation within the blockchain industry. It is very important because a novice in the blockchain industry will not know much about a project, right? Now this is the team behind Polygon Matic as a case study here. Now these are the founders, these are all the founders, right? Now I want to see how knowledgeable these guys are about blockchain. Are they real human beings? Are they verifiable? You understand, even though there are some projects that like to run anonymously, it is allowed, right? It doesn't mean the project will not do it, it doesn't mean the project is not legit, right? But it is important that, you know, projects review their team so that people can vet, you know, for themselves and see that okay, this is a real project, and then know how to invest into it. So these are their social media handles. This takes you, once you click any of these, it takes you directly to their social media handle. Now let's say we want to see if this one is a real human being. When we click on that LinkedIn, it takes us to his LinkedIn profile, right? To, you know, Let's see what information we can get about him, right? These are all the activities he has been involved recently, right? Now these are his experiences, which is a very important aspect to consider, right? He has been a co-founder in the Polygon for 4 years and 4 months, right? Now he has worked as a data scientist, okay, software artisan, senior software, engineer. So he has all these experiences, right? He's a software developer, so he knows a thing or two about developing a project. Now these are his skills, these are his endorsements, right? So these are his recommendations, like people that recommend him. These are more like the people he looks up to, okay? So you can see that this guy, for instance, is a real person. It's not an AI generated image, right? So we can do the same thing for each of the teams, just to be sure, right? Just to be sure they are not ghost founders. So that's one of the things you want to look at. You want to look at the team behind the project. So this is how you do it. You can see that this guy also has he has been a co-founder and a CEO at this blockchain company. This one too. So you can see that they have a bit of experience, in the blockchain industry. So that is how you look into the team. Now another thing you want to look at is the white paper. Another thing you want to look at is the white paper of the project. Let's see where we get the white paper. It should be somewhere where we have the white paper. Usually there's a link. Okay, it should be it. Okay, that is it. So you can see Matic white paper, you can see the light paper, right? The difference is just that for a start, they may release a light paper just to give a few insights of everything the project is about, and then they will go on to update it and bring out a white paper. So you can download. I shared a tutorial on how to read a white paper also. So you find it and you learn how to read a white paper. Okay, so that is that. And then you want to look at events, right? You want to look at events that surrounds Polygon. Now, to do that, you make use of this website, CoinMarketCal, right? Not CoinMarketCap. CoinMarketCal as in calendar. Now when you go to the website, it's more like an event tracker for every crypto asset in the market. So if there's any asset you want to see upcoming events for, this is where you get it. So you can come here to see if there's any upcoming related event for the particular project you're looking at, right? Now you can do that by just searching. You can do that by just searching for the project. I think there's a way you can search for it. There should be a way you can search for it. Okay, this is it. So you can search for it. See, so it will bring out everything that has Matic, Matic on it. So if there's any upcoming events, you'd have seen it here. Alright, so all you need to do is just search for the asset here, and it will give you a list of its upcoming events, right? Now I've given you one. So that is that about the project metrics. Now the next thing you want to consider is the market sentiment. The market sentiment is another thing you want to consider. By market sentiment, we mean how people feel about this project, how people react about this project, you know. And to do that, you want to go to their social media handles, right? You want to go to their social media handles. You want to go to Twitter. You want to go to their Telegram. Now, when you go to their Telegram, you want to see how effective the admin of this project is. You want to see how effective the admin is. Now, you want to see how many persons, how many subscribers they have. Now, you can see that they have this total number of subscribers, right? Now, let's view the group. Now, you can see, you can try to see how the admin, you know, communicates, how frequently the admin responds to people's question. You want to also take note of bots, right? You want to take note of bot activity in the group. There are some projects you go to, they will not be admins, they will just assign duties to bots, right? So that is why. So you want to really come here, see how they communicate or how they interact with their community members. See questions people are raising about the projects, the concerns and all that. So that is one of the things you can do here. Now, another place to track the activity is by using your Twitter. Now, you can just go to Twitter. You can just go to Twitter and use the search bar to search for the, you know, the project ticker. Let's say Matic, for instance. You can just search Matic, and then, you know, when you search, you see what people are, you know, saying about the project. You want to see how people are reacting about the project, right? And you will see people's sentiments about it too. Now, another thing you would consider when running your fundamental analysis is the utility surrounding a token, right? Now, the utility surrounding an asset is what tells you the performance of the asset over time, right? Even though that is not the only thing that tells you how a project will perform, there are some projects that are community based. There are some projects that their performance is based on the community behind it. Let's say for instance Cardano, right? You can see that so far the price action for Cardano has been very shitty, but they have a strong community behind them, right? Their community, they have a strong community of believers, people who actually believe in the project, you know, and are backing it. So that is what has been holding up the price of Cardano over time, right? So that you can see community is also very important. The community size of projects is very important, that you consider the number of, you know, group participants they have. You understand? So going back to what I was saying earlier on, you want to look at the utility surrounding a particular token. You want to see over time what will, you know, help push up the price of this asset, right? So you want to see how useful the coin is, right? Does it have real world applications or use cases, you know, things like that. So when you go, let's go back to Polygon. Let's try to see if there's, okay, now going to the token, it should give you a detailed info about the token. Now you can see right here that Matic is an ERC20. ERC is Ethereum, right? ERC20 tokens are Ethereum based tokens, right? So it was developed under Ethereum and then they switched to multi-chain. So it has explained to you what Matic is here. Now this here tells you the utility surrounding the Matic token. The Matic token serves dual purpose, securing the network via staking and being used for payment of transaction fees. Now you can see that those are use cases for the Matic token. So for a project, for a shitcoin, for instance, that does not have any use case, you see that what actually drives the price up over time is just community and hype, right? Now, when the community dies down and the hype dies down, is the reason why you see them collapse the way they do, because there's no consistent use case for the asset. It is not being, you know, actually being used for anything, right? Unlike Matic that can be used for, you know, paying of the of gas fees on the Polygon chain and as rewards for people that staked their asset. You know, you can see that shitcoins are, you know, totally a different thing altogether. They don't have any use case particularly to say that, okay, this is what would drive, in the absence of community and hype, this is what will keep giving us value, you know, over time on this token, right? So watch out for that. Now, this also tells you where you can get the exchange, right? I'm more interested, this an area I'm more interested in, where it gives you a breakdown. Okay, let's get another project that gives us a breakdown of the tokenomics. We call it tokenomics, right? Let's get a different project that will give us a breakdown of the tokenomics. Let's see. You can see the use case for Polkadot also as governance token, staking, bonding. So it is very important. It's very important. I'm not getting anything on all this. Let me get a different asset that we can see what the tokenomics looks like. Let me see. Let's use the Phi Kingdom. See if we can get information about the tokenomics. So projects recently have been trusting on CoinGecko and CoinMarketCap to, you know, give informations about their tokenomics. So many of them just tend to leave it out on their website. But I need to find one. I need to find one that has its tokenomics explained so that you can see what it looks like. You can see the things you need to watch out for on their tokenomics. It is very important that you see this. Let's see if we have one here. Fuse token. All right. Now the area I wanted to talk about is the token distribution. You want to see how this token, you know, has been distributed or has been scheduled to be distributed, right? You can see that from the tokenomics of this asset we're looking at, 65 million of it, right, which is 21.7% of the total supply, has been, you know, assigned or has been mapped out for feature development pool, right? Like development of the projects for feature. And then you can see that 130 million fuse for bootstrap. I don't know whatever this shit is. I don't really. This is a very shitty tokenomics, you know, or explanation for your tokenomics, right? But my area. Just give me a minute. We need to get an asset that will really break down tokenomics the way I want it, so that I can explain the things that you need to look out for when checking these things. It is very important that you see this. So let's see if we have the tokenomics explained anywhere. Token metrics. Alright. Now, let's look at this one for instance. This is the token allocation. It's the same thing as you know, token distribution. So you can see that this one gives us more detail about how the token is distributed. So this is a play to end game that we're looking at. So you can see that 6% of the total supply of the token was allocated to for private sale, right? Private investors. These are some of the steps projects take to raise funds, you know, to finance their projects, right? They first of all sell to private investors as a much at a much much cheaper rate, and then IDO, right? IDO on Launchpad, you can see that 2% of the total supply was assigned to that. You can see that they are listing on PancakeSwap, 1% was assigned as liquidity. Now you can see that 20% of the asset has been allocated for play to earn as rewards when you're playing the game, right? 20%. You can also see that 20% has been also allocated for staking rewards. People that stake their token, right? Total supply, 20% of the total supply has been assigned, you know, as rewards to people that will stake their token. Now 6% has been assigned for the ecosystem funding, right, to fund the ecosystem. Now this is the areas that you should focus on: the team, the advisor, and some marketing. Sometimes they differentiate it. They have the team, they have the advisors, they have the marketing. You want to be very 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 conscious of, you know, the total supply that is allocated to them, because if the more token that is assigned to the team or advisors or whatever, the more tendency there is of, you know, them dumping, you know, on the token, right? If 25% of the total supply of this asset was allocated to the team members, now you want to know how many members of the team, you know, is this 25% allocated for, right? You want to also know the advisors. Who are these advisors? So this is a very huge number. Any asset that has more than 10% allocated to either the team, advisors, and the rest of them is a red flag, right? It means there is a possibility of a dump, because they would also want to sell their tokens, right? So if they start dumping and then 25% of their total supply is owned by the team, what happens when they decide to dump it? These are some of the things you consider, right? Now DEX liquidity, decentralized exchange listings. I don't know why they should have this different from this. These things should be together. So these are some of the key, you know, figures you want to look at. Reserves. What is this particular 12% reserve for? What plan do they have for this reserve, right? Now these are some of the questions you can raise when you join their social media platforms. You know, you can ask, according to your tokenomics, that you have 12% of your total supply reserve. What, you know, is this token reserved for? What is this reservation for, right? You can ask that question and then see the response they give you. You know, these are some of the things you want to ask in their groups before you even look at, you know, investing your money into it. You want to ask critical questions. 25% of this token was assigned to your team. Why? You know, questions like that. So this is a chart of the token distribution. You can see that a large chunk of the supply was assigned to the team, right? That is a red flag. Now let's go back to see who are these team members that 25% of this token was assigned to. Now a red flag would be if these team members are not verifiable, right? If we cannot verify these team members, it is a red flag. Now look at the core team, right? Now they are saying, you can see that the core team is made up of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 persons, right? Now there is no way for us to even verify that these persons are real people, that they are not AI generated images. You can see that there is no social media link to their profile. So this is a red flag for me. Now you have project managers, all right, you have all these people, You have all these people as your team members, right? Now, remember that part of the token allocation was, you know, allocated to advisors. Now, we have only three people serving as advisors. So why was this particular number of token allocated to three, just three persons? Now you have the total number of team members. And like I said earlier, they should incorporate both the team and the advisors together, just the same way it has done here. So all these allocations, 25%. So if you add 25 plus to this, 28%. 28% of the token has been assigned to the core team members. So that is too much. Now what you want to look out for is 10%. Anything 10, 12 below that, you are good. But these figures, anything above 10-12% is an outrageous figure, right? So that is that on tokenomics, right? I hope this is clear enough. So another thing you want to look at is their roadmap. Their roadmap can be added to you know, when you're looking into you know, their project metrics, you can also look at their roadmap. Their roadmap, of course, should be contained in their white paper, right? You want to see their future plans. You know, this also gives you an insight on, you know, how this token is going to perform over time, right? You want to look at what they have, you know, in line to come. So you can see that they have these plans. This project, for instance, have this plan in place, right? So these are one of the things you want to consider. These are some of the things you want to consider. All right. So another important ticker that you need to look out for in the roadmap is exchange listing. Exchange listing is one of the things that, you know, boost the performance of any asset, right? The more exchange that the token is listed, the better the token will perform, in the sense that more exchange listing means there is more possibility for people to have access to buying the token, right? Usually when projects like this launch, they usually launch on decentralized exchange like PancakeSwap, right? So they have to go on and, you know, enlist on centralized exchanges like Binance and KuCoin and the rest of them, so more people can have access to purchase this particular token. It is not everyone that knows how to interact on decentralized exchange like PancakeSwap. So you want to see more exchange listing for the particular, you know, project you're looking into, right? So these are just some of the important metrics that you need to look out for when you are considering your fundamentals on any asset, right? So it is important that you sit down and do a critical and a thorough look into these things that I've mentioned, right? Especially the tokenomics, especially the team behind it, everything that we have talked about, the utility surrounding the token and the rest. So these are some of the key things that you look into when you're performing your fundamental. Fundamental is not something you just rush up on. You want to take time. You want to research on social media. You want to see what people are talking about this particular asset, right? So that is that. I hope this helps.